agriculture is one of the critical industries driving the economy of Malawi. However, according to a 2015 report, the cost of gender gap in agricultural productivity in Malawi, Tanzania and Uganda by World Bank and United Nations, there's a huge gender gap in agriculture with more men taking center stage. According to the report, closing those gender gaps in Malawi could lead to an increase of $100 million, an equivalent to 50 billion Malawi kwacha, in gross domestic product, and lift 238,000 Malawians out of poverty each year over a 10-year period. We learn of how women in the northern region of Malawi are pulling through in a bid to have a share of the public and private procurement expenditures. Even though more women are engaged in agriculture, women's posts do not have as much access to male family labor. And also, men produce high-value products because they have better access to better agricultural implements. Though in recent times, the birth of Advocacy Week has helped more women to grow from small-scale farming to entrepreneurship, they continue to face interconnected barriers to access equal economic opportunities as compared to their male counterparts. For instance, even though public procurement is one of the many opportunities the women could capitalize on to grow, not many women have the capacity to participate in open contracting. At the same time, the few who have the capacity are struggling to make it through successfully. Voice of Praise Women's Association is a grouping of 56 women in the areas of Mchengodua, Chigwele, Malivenji and Nyezini in the area of traditional authority Mtwalo in Mzimba district. Even though the grouping has capacity to produce on large scale agricultural produce such as garlic, tomatoes, watermelons, ginger, cabbage, among others, lack of proper markets has forced them to rely on door-to-door deliveries for sales. Irene Banda is the chairperson of the grouping.
The marketing side is very difficult because we cannot reach the platforms that can help us market our products properly because we don't have money. So we usually go door-to-door. Or we usually call the phone numbers that we have. We feel like I think these can consume our products. Maybe we get them from the radio, we get them from the TV, from the newspapers. So whatever we come across, every opportunity that we have, it's either we go there physically or we communicate through phone. Yes, we've tried several times, but we find hiccups. Usually those who already have names, they make like private communications apart from the ordinary communications that we have, and usually they are men. And they have like the communications that they have made, like those who are into supply, like men, they have their groups, so they notify each other. Then the other thing is they also call the management. So the management, apart from having like the normal procedure that they have, they also have the private phone calls that they have. Then the other thing is, we have a big challenge of which we feel like the government can intervene, we can be helped. On the bid form, there is one condition on the criteria that you have to fulfill, which they say you have to produce a bank statement, a bank certified statement. You don't have money in the bank. Because the bank cannot give you money, you can't borrow from the bank, you keep the money in our village circle, like village banks, then your account can't produce that which you have. Because if you keep your money in the bank, then you cannot borrow. You better keep where you can borrow the money, which is the village bank. Then the one who is going to buy your product is demanding a bank certified statement, which has to show that you are supplying. And at the same time, there is also another condition which they say you have to produce reference consumers of your products. Now, you don't have like any public body which is consuming your products apart from the individuals that you produce. Where do you get the reference?
Mm-hmm. Aside selling produce fresh from the farm, Voice of Praise Association has taken a step further to locally process their products into ginger and garlic juice, while they turn baobab flour and seeds into milk and vegetables. Banda explains more.
This is juice produced from ginger, and it's good for our health, especially this time that people are looking for ginger and garlic for the flu that we have and some stuff that would like to have it for them. So because people have a history that ginger is bitter and stuff like that, we always make it so colorful to make it attractive and make them forget the history that they have about the bitterness of ginger. And this is garlic. It's also homegrown, and it's also processed the way we process ginger. And it's also colored for the sake of those who have the fear of taking garlic in the name of its bitter. So it's good for our health and for the patients as well.
Selling uncertified and unbranded produce is also a hassle for the women. Mwema Investment is proof that an individual farmer can rise into a successful supplier. However, for the investment's proprietor Memory Mafuriwa, being a female supplier has its hurdles, as she explains.
I can't make the real pricing because sana, you know, they are from foreign countries and they are Malawian. So if we make the pricing here, the fixed price, they reduce the price to the extent that they need to win instead of it win. So that's how that is the main challenge. I'm fighting for that. And the other thing, to get the product here in Zuzu, I have to get the value chain product, like the disposal trays and the lapping papers. And right now I'm fighting to have the sticker on the product. So those things are very expensive here in Zuzu. I have to source people around and ask people around from Lilongwe and Brenta to get the product to give it to me. So those are the main things I can say. Only a few people, they are helping me to have the actual product in Sana, because I'm mainly into carrots. Right now in my garden I have only a few carrots. But green pepper, green beans, eggplants, and other like ginger, I have to source it to the farmers who are able to give it to me on a short period of time. And I should give them money right away. So the farmers need to get the money right away. While I'm just applying to Sana, I get the money when the manager asks me for the invoice, maybe in 2 to 3 weeks. So that's the challenge. So the farmer needs the money right away. I have to source the money where I can get and give it to them, and I get the product and put it inside.
On the other hand, for Jacinta Jerry of Mzuzu Livestock Cooperative, it's easier if women affiliate themselves with a cooperative or an association, because it's easier to win a contract as a group than as an individual. Jacinta explains in this interview.
I started very, very little with farm produce. I was selling farm produce. Thereafter, I engaged myself in agriculture. I grow vegetables, tomatoes, and I keep chickens and pigs. Especially pigs is the one which I depend on very much. I am a member of NABIWI. I have been in NABIWI for a long time. We have been helped in business management, how I can make agriculture as a business. Then I'm also a member of WITU Kitchen, which is a cooperative. We process tomato, we can it and put it in bottles that we sell in the shops. Yeah, as an association, it's easy, especially as a cooperative. At WITU, it was easy because we had a chance of selling produce in shops like ShopRite, like in big shops in Lilongwe, But that is for the cooperative. But as myself, it's very difficult to do that on my own. Yes, I have had those chances several times because I attend some workshops where we associate, we network with other business ladies. But still, there's a big challenge, especially as a woman. It's very difficult to find the chance on your own. You can try your best, even getting a loan at the bank is too difficult. You go there, they'll say, surety. And if you say, I have a house, they say you have a deed. So if you don't have a deed, you can't contest. So even if we meet with our friends, but still more, there's limited space where you can find a chance to compete with others who are at who are well to do.
It has also been discovered that most women, even if they are able to produce products, they lack capacity to produce more. Joyce Sichari is the chairperson from Zuzu Disability Organization. She believes that women should be empowered financially so that they can be able to scale up their production, since most tenders require huge suppliers. She explains.
My name is Joyce Sichari. I'm the director from Zuzu Disability Organization. For me, like a woman who has a physical disability, I can see women in business here in Mzuzu meet a lot of challenges. As women, we have goals to achieve, but it's not easy to reach them. This is because most people look down on both women and other people with physical disabilities. For example, as women, we may see in the newspaper that there is an advert for beads, for work suits, sweaters, masks, which you also produce. But we find that when we apply, they doubt our capabilities since we have a small working capital. Sometimes just by looking at us, they conclude that we'll not manage. Disability should not be a reason for us to be sidelined. Like in my case, I have 20 acres of farmland, but I cannot exhaust it in farming because my capital is so small. I have a certificate in public procurement and contracting, and I would love to be handling contracts, but it's not easy to secure one because I'm a woman with physical disability.
Pamela Campariro adds that for women to earn more from their business, they need to take their time to look for ideal markets before cultivation of their crops or production, so that when the products are ready, they should have a ready market.
My name is Pamela Gambalilo. I do agribusiness. I ventured into the farming business 5 years ago. I grow maize, soya beans, groundnuts, and tobacco. Mostly, what I've noticed is that a lot of women go into agribusiness without proper vision. Most women farm just for the sake of farming without having proper direction. Also, most women fail to benefit because they don't have capacity for large-scale farming. For example, one may be in seed production, but the requirement is that you must have at least 10 acres of land. It is hard for a woman with minimal resources to meet such a standard. At least if there was a chance for loans for women, and that they should be trained. Most of us women farm, but we do not know where to sell our produce. As a result, we end up selling to vendors at very cheap prices.
On a small scale.
Regardless of all the challenges, Theodora Makata, a procurement expert in Mzuzu City, encourages women to take their chances in procurement and open contracting because contracts are twice as rewarding, as she explains in this interview.
We usually follow the act which was established in 2017. That's the Public and Procurement Disposal Act, which we usually follow when we do the opening contract and the every process in procurement. In section 40 of the act, it tells us about the public invitation. This is like the open contract. It's open to everyone. So we have to publicize it openly. That means you find the tenders, the open contracts in the newspapers, even in the website. That means it's open to every person to apply. Yeah, so in that section, there's section 40, there's section 42, whereby it tells us about the submission of those open contracts or bids. While in section 43, it tells us about the bid opening, whereby it's open to everyone also. Everyone who has applied the tender, we usually tells them to come and see when we open the bid, so that it has to be transparent and accountability. This is the registration certificate, which they obtain from the registrar general. Then they must have the PPDA certificate. This is the certificate which they obtain in the Public and Procurement Disposal Assets Authority. This certificate is usually required because it's just like a mandatory, whereby if you want to deal with the government institutions, you must have this PPDA certificate. And the other one, maybe we can just add on the TCC, that's the Tax Clearance Certificate. This is MRI thing, whereby every company which want to participate in the bidding process, they must have the TCC certificate also. These are just a few things which are just in.
Despite many challenges faced by women like Irene in entering the domain of public procurement in northern Malawi, the Open Contracting Advocacy Project by CISANET has become a hubbing of unlimited opportunities for women in agribusiness.
This is a project that we're working together with People Innovation for Women and Girls, but we got funding from CISANET. Mainly, this project is about empowering women so that they too can be able to have a chance in open contracting, particularly women engaged in agribusiness. Because we noticed that as much as more women are engaged in agriculture, but most of them, they only do it on small scale, where they only manage to earn enough only for their families. But it is very important for these women to earn more than just on household level. So when CISANET came to us with the idea about engaging the women and enlightening them on procurement processes and open contracting. To us, we saw it as a plus, because it's also one way of helping us to reaching out to the women who are also our clients as a media.
The awareness of the country's new public procurement policies has led to a rush in registration of new women-owned enterprises in the hope of securing future business contracts through transparent public procurement processes. If scaled by willing partners like HIVOS, women across Malawi are on a path to change.
What I want to add is that as a woman on your own, you can do something, because I have got that experience. I have told you that I'm doing business on my own. I've managed to raise my children through the agribusiness, especially rearing pigs. The pigs have really done something to me. I have bought a brand new sofa at 350 Malawian kwacha cash, which people lay by, but myself, I didn't. And I have got a garden where I have got some vegetables, which I always sell. So I find money, and I am encouraging my female friends, especially the widows, that they should be engaged in agriculture. And agriculture is something that you don't miss, because if you don't sell, you eat it. So that's my only way that I can say to the other Malawi women.
So to the young people out there, it's about passion. You have to have a passion to whatever you are doing. Whether it's little that is giving you in your pocket, but at least you are doing something out there. Because I have linked up almost three people to Sana. This certain woman who got the carrots, fresh carrots, fresh green paper, but he just go to the open market and sell it, but with a little profit. When I go to her, I tell her to give me a bunch of the things, and I give the money right away to him. And he's happy because I'm giving market to him. And also there's another one who is at Kibago. He always say that you are my very best customer, I can't let you down because I don't have any product. He tried his best to source some product from somewhere to give it to me so that I should go to his son.
With Malawi's economy leaning on agriculture sector, it is hoped that open contracting will graduate many women farmers from poverty to prosperity as they clinch larger contracts in the country's million-dollar sector.
We are handcuffed. We have the ideas which are rotting in us. So we'd like to ask all society members who can help, be it the government or non-governmental organization or individuals, to help us to set up our factory, or to give us our working capital as minimal as they can manage. As we are talking here, we have a buyer who wants to buy stuff from us, but because we cannot give surety that we'll buy fertilizer and the other farm stuffs by the end of this month, we are about to lose that chance again. So it is my cry that it will not be just us, but let the government put some help and put some measures that can help all women in Malawi and the youth as well.
However, procurement officers have encouraged women to be vigilant.
Most of the bidders, they lack knowledge when they are maybe preparing their bids. But on the, as I said, on the public invitation, we usually put the phone numbers whereby maybe if they don't understand what to do, they have to call the procuring entity. They will get all the information from them. The other issue is on the, they don't ask, like from other people who have maybe tried once, like what to do, what is needed. As I said earlier, procurement, mostly we follow the procedures, and it's like a standard thing whereby we use this act, Public and Procurement Disposal Act, whereby everything which we do, everything, every process, every procurement process, we have to follow the act.
Chalo cha Ethiopia, vakasirwa.